Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about the brand new XVive PX, which is a headphone mixer, but it gives you the ability to mix three different channels into this one unit, which is pretty cool. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear, no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, XVive sent this to me to give you guys a review, and I did do a full review of this myself, and it's pretty cool. It's a pretty cool unit. I'm pretty excited about it. The unit itself is this. We can see that there's an input 1, an input 2, and an input 3. Now, this can be powered over PoE, which means that it can be powered from a DC 9-volt 2-amp with the center being the negative, like a standard Boss power supply. Now, that can be actually powered over this little thing right here. So this is the PXB. And this is how we get our audio plugged in to this unit with the PX-A. And we can actually send this over a shielded Cat5 cable. So we can just grab a shielded Cat5 and we plug it into one side. And we plug the other side into the PX-A. And then if we have a 9-volt 2-amp with the center being negative, we can plug it into this spot, and this will actually power this unit remotely, which is pretty cool. So you can have a very long Cat5 cable that's shielded, and this will pass your audio and the power to this unit. Now, I don't have one of those 9 volts, so I went ahead and put in two Amazon AAAs. And so inside of this unit right here are a few little switches. Now, these switches allow you to change whether each channel is going to the left or the right of your headphone jack right here. So currently I have this set on input 1 is on the left. We can see that the little switch is up. Input 2 is on the right. And input 3 is on both for mono. Now, if you just wanted to have the ability of having three mono things, you'd want all of those switches to be up. But I'm wanting to show you a pretty cool way of setting this up with a stereo on input 1 and 2, and then the click on 3. So I have these switches set there, and I'm going to toss my AAA batteries back in. And once I've done that, I want to switch this to battery, and that way it can be turned on. Now, I do have a direct box over here and a headphone cable so we can listen to what's going on. Trying to get all these cables to the point where you can see them. Okay, so the PXB, which is this unit, is what we connect into our mixer. So we can see that I have three XLRs here, and they're numbered 1, 2, and 3. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug those into my aux outputs 1, 2, and 3 from my Behringer XR mixer right here. So here is input 1, plug that into there, input 2, plug that into aux 2, and input 3, plug it into aux 3. Now, on my XR mixer, I have my bus 1 as a stereo bus, and then my bus 3 is a mono. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up a drum mix on my 1 and 2 being stereo, and then I'm going to set up my bus 3 being my click track. That way I can give my drummer the ability of having a left-right mix in their head of their drums, and then a adjustment for their click level on 3. So to do that, I went to bus 1 and 2, and I went ahead and went to the channel, and linked my mix bus 1 and my mix bus 2. And then my bus 3 is just mono, and here we go. So on bus 3, I've went ahead and turned up the click, and on bus 1 and 2, I've given a little bit of a mix here. And so now what we can do is we can go over to the XVive PX, and we can turn up. There's my left, there's my right, and here is my click track. Now I have the ability of adjusting the levels of these things. Now, I also have the overall volume of my mix right here. So So this is one way of using this system. Now, if I was wanting to have three different mixes, let's set that up. So what I'm going to do is turn this off real quick, open this back up, and change all of these switches to be on. So we can see my channel one here. I'm going to switch that to be on both the left and the right. And channel two, I'm also going to set that to be on the left and the right. And channel three is also turned on with the left and the right. So now I can put my batteries back in. And turn this back on. And then on my X-Air mixer, I am going to make this mix bus mono. So I have my mix bus one selected, so I'll go ahead and unlink this. And I'm going to set this up as a drums on mix bus one. And my mix bus two is going to have guitars, keys, and bass. So here we go. And we can even put the click in here. We'll put it in at plus one. And so I have my drums now. And then I have the rest of my band plus click. And then I can put my vocals on my bus three. If you're not a singer and you're just a drummer. Or if you're one of the musicians on this group.
Outro.
Now this unit is pretty cool. I went ahead and did a smart testing on this, and it is a full 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, so it's great audio fidelity in this. So you won't notice any difference of lacking bass or lacking treble in this unit, which is great. Now, one thing to mention about powering over DC is that with the 2-amp 9-volt supply, you can actually break it out and power 5 of these PX units over that one DC wall wart. Now, XVive also makes a thing called a PX Hub, which allows you to connect the output of your PX-B into the input of your PX Hub, and then power 5 of these devices off of that one PX Hub. The other benefit of that PX Hub is it then shares those 3 audio channels with all of those PX devices that are connected to that hub. So it's a pretty cool system for giving you musicians the ability of mixing a personal monitor for themselves using just 3 outputs on your console. It gives the ability for them to adjust maybe themselves and a band mix or however they want to have that set up. Now, one last thing to note about the XVive PX is this is a all metal case, except right here, this is just plastic, but it does feel very good. So it has some solid connections, this is an EtherCon connector. So we can end up using a shielded Cat5 with the EtherCon connector, and that's going to be a much more robust connection than this. Now, if you do happen to use a non-shielded Cat5 cable, then it's not going to pass the audio ground to the PX unit. So you can power and still have audio with a non-shielded Cat5, but for the best audio experience, I would suggest using a shielded Cat5 for all of your connections. Now, if you do happen to have any questions, or if there's a piece of gear that you would love me to review or check out, please put those in the comments section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. Now, if you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com, where I have a whole bunch of articles, tips, and tricks, and some products that you can download for your Behringer XR18. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.